As promised, last segment, I told you we're going to talk about a picture that has gone viral on the internet. And you may or may not have seen this, but basically a group of teachers from a local school district, the Fox School District, showed up at this women's march downtown and posed with a bunch of signs that you could argue are have some offensive wording on them. And they posted it to social media. And immediately people recognized them, maybe the parents of some of their students, and said, you know, wait a minute, is this appropriate if you're in a first grade classroom to be posting things like this to social media about your private parts? About your lady parts, so to speak. And already today, the superintendent of the Fox School District has responded to my request, to my question to him as to, well, what's the school district going to do about this? Let me get to my guest right now. Doris Borgelt is my guest. She is the one who had drawn my attention to this because she reposted the picture on her Facebook page. Doris, how are you?
Okay, how are you doing?
I'm doing well. Thank you for giving me a few minutes on the air because I know you're at work today. What drew your attention to this picture to begin with? And I'm assuming that you actually recognized some of the teachers when you first saw it.
Yes, I did. And what drew me to it were the signs. The signs were, I just thought, in bad taste.
Keep your religion out of my vagina is one of the signs. I'll just say it. That's not one of the seven dirty words you can't say on TV. It's, you know, it's biology. That's one of them. They get worse from there. And I'm not going to repeat the others. People are welcome to go to Facebook and look for the photo. We're going to post it up on our Facebook page as well, so you can look at it. And we're going to link to a picture of it, so you can see what this is about. What's the reaction that you've gotten from your friends to this, Doris?
Well, most of the reaction has been not in favor of them posing with the signs. Now, I have had some reaction that was not very good. Mostly that's in private.
Well, people are attacking you for even reposting it. Why do you think that is?
Well, I guess they're not happy with the content or happy with it being spread over the internet, but it was posted. It was public, it was posted on the March site, and it was shared with a lot of their friends.
Now, you and I have spoken about this off air, and I'm not going to identify these individual teachers, but one of them is a first grade teacher, and some others work in various roles within the district, correct?
Correct.
What other grades do we have covered here? Do you have any idea?
That I have no idea. Like I said, I've been otherwise occupied this morning.
Yeah, sure you have. You know, when I look at it, my initial response was, these teachers have every right in the world to go out and express their opinion and go to this march, and I'd stand up for their right to march and state their opinion about anything. However, we spend a lot of time as parents, I know I do, lecturing my now 18-year-old child, who's a senior in high school, to be cautious what he posts on social media, because it matters.
It does matter. That's correct.
And I mean, is that where the trouble lies here as far as you're concerned?
Well, they tell the students not to do it, but then they turn around and do the exact same thing they're telling the students not to do.
Yeah. You've gotten some nasty responses to this on your social media page.
Oh, yes, I have, but I'm a big girl.
Yeah, I saw you had reposted something that said you were part of the 30 million woman march back in November when you went into the voting booth to elect Donald Trump.
That is correct.
Well, Doris, listen, I appreciate your time today. Thank you for giving me a few minutes, and thank you for drawing this to my attention.
No problem. Thanks. Have a great day, and I hope it all gets settled.
Yeah, I do too, and I don't. I appreciate you, Doris. Thank you. I'm not quite sure what's going to happen, but here's the deal, and I'm just going to read you the letter that's being sent out today to parents in the Fox School District. Jim Wipke, Dr. Jim Wipke, is the principal, is the superintendent down there. He said he's heard from a lot of parents, and he's answered several emails about this today. This has been his reply. He wants to thank people for taking the time to reach out to express their frustration and their opinion regarding the Facebook postings that have included the pictures of Fox C6 staff at this march. He wanted to be the first to apologize on behalf of the district, although we respect any citizen's right to protest and their freedom of speech. The signs were not in good taste. I was very disappointed when I learned that those depicted were indeed our staff members. To the extent that this is a personnel matter, we cannot discuss the details with the public, but I assure you this situation will be addressed. So I know that in some districts, staff members have social media policies as well. And I'm guessing that that's what we're dealing with here. I from some other administrators, I know that they would have a fit if that were their teachers. Now, if it had just been a simple picture of them at the march, that's one thing. That's not what it is. They took pictures of people who had some signs that you basically wouldn't want your grade schooler or middle schooler to read, and these were posted on social media. As we lecture our kids, you never know what's going to end up on social media. That's kind of the point here. Chris, welcome into the show. What's your comment?
Yeah, my main thing is I don't understand why she's so upset about that when she's probably one of the people, I don't know if she did or not, who most likely voted for Trump, and don't worry, I'm not going to say it, who said grab her by the blank. So it just kind of seems a little like hypocritical.
Well, yeah, really. But Donald Trump said that in a, and I'm not defending what he said, but he said that in a private conversation that was then released to the public by NBC News. So that's far different than walking down the street in a public march holding a sign that says those words on it. I mean, that's my only point. And you're right. She did vote for Donald Trump. But the lady that posted this on her Facebook page, where it was drawn to my attention, is certainly not the only one that reposted it, including the teachers who originally posted it. I don't know any of them personally, but they put it up on their page.
Well, I understand that. I understand all your points, but Donald Trump, even when he said that, he was still a public figure, and being a public figure of his stature, everything's going to make it to the media. Everything is. He should know better.
He probably should have, Chris, but I don't think it addresses the point here. So if I walked down the street out here on Market Street with a sign that said something like that, and somebody took a picture of it and posted it to social media, I would expect repercussions from my workplace because I represent this radio station. In this particular case, these people represent their school district. And just like students can get in trouble for social media posts off campus, teachers can as well. It's just something I don't think was very well thought out. And I also think that sign is a perfect example of why this women's march... A lot of people were deceived about what this was about. Just let me say that. A lot of people who participated in this march were deceived about what this was really about. Rose, do you have the soapbox up over there? Can you hit that for me?
Now, Mark Cox, soapbox.
So Hillary Clinton has already tweeted out her approval of the march this weekend. Hillary Clinton's tweet, scrolling through the images of the hashtag Women's March, it's awe-inspiring. Hope it brought joy to others as it did to me. And then you see signs like this, regulate your blank and not my blank, held up by teachers marching down the street in St. Louis. you know, you're entitled to your opinion. Nobody argues about that. But the bottom line with this is a good example of it. You've got to be held responsible to your employer. You do. And that's the problem here. So to the march itself, and not specifically this photo, I say this. Don't buy the media line that this was some awe-inspiring turnout strictly in opposition to Donald Trump. Because that's false. That's not what the march this weekend was about. I have no problem with their right to march. They can march till kingdom come. Let them march every day, all day. I don't care. But the photographic proof is right in front of anybody who wants to go look for it. The sexism, the anger, and the hate expressed by a lot of the walkers this weekend is nothing new for the feminism movement. It isn't. Go back to 2004 and look at the Women's March on Washington. Just type it into Google and look at the images. Who do you see there? Gloria Steinem, Ashley Judd, Nancy Pelosi, Eleanor Schmiel. Did you know that before you went out and marched, if you were one of the marchers? Let me ask that question. Because there may be some new faces this weekend, some people that were sucked into the false notion that we're going to go march to show our opposition to Donald Trump. But guess what? In 2004, all you have to do is replace the person with the R after their name. Then it was George W. Bush, because they were upset with his policies. So it's not about Donald Trump. It's about somehow feeling threatened by the policies of somebody who's a Republican who doesn't agree with your worldview. If you're like Madonna, she may want to blow you up if she doesn't agree with your worldview. And they've been preaching the same company line for years and years and years. And the funny thing is, we only hear from them when a Republican occupies the White House. It's okay. That's not the only time their false narratives about equal pay and contraception coverage and insulting signs wishing that the mothers of all Republicans believed in abortion, then they wouldn't have to worry about this. So in their view, they'd have no opposition if everybody believed in abortion, because there's a good chance the person that opposed them might have been one of the lucky ones that got aborted. That's kind of the sick line of reasoning. Imagine wishing for the in utero murder of all of your opponents so you wouldn't have any opponents. I'm not making this up. Go look for the picture of people holding a sign that said, if John Ashcroft's mother had just been pro-choice, the world would be a better place. That's kind of sick and twisted. And I don't think that all of the people that marched this weekend believe that. Feel free and call and tell me if I'm wrong, but I don't think that all the people that marched this weekend believe that. But the organizers of the march do. The Ashley Judds and the Gloria Steinems and the Madonnas and the Michael Moores, they all believe that. To them, that's what the march was about. It wasn't about, they got you riled up over Donald Trump, but it wasn't about Donald Trump. That's not what it was about. Again, you're free to march all day long. I'll support your right to do that as long as it's peaceful. However, don't be deceived about what this march was about. That's what I'm saying. I'm going to get to more of your phone calls on this situation in the Fox School District.